The circus is back in town. No, I'm not talking about down at Sarasota where I'm from, where whole Ringling Brothers and Barnum Bailey, that's a whole thing got started. We got the political circus back in town. What we've got is, well,
golf is over.
Yeah, golf is over. We got, who's going to be speaker? Where is a compromise going to come from? Are we going to get a Keystone pipeline? All that good stuff, vetoes, executive actions, fun stuff. My hope is that we actually get some politicians that are going to actually stick by their guns and actually do what they said they were going to do based upon how they got themselves elected. What about you?
Well, how about just getting things done, period?
Yeah, but to me, it depends on what meaning getting things done. Because sometimes they can do more harm than when they actually try to get things done. That's when you end up with bad legislation. I'm under the belief that from now on, we have too many laws. So if you ever want to pass a new law or a new rule, you've got to eliminate 10.
Well, that makes sense because some of these rules, if something about marrying your dog, I mean, the fact that we actually have to have laws that talk about that, that's concerning in of itself. And perhaps that can be devoted to another video. But, you know, my sticking point is this, you know, it just seems to me like for such a long time, we haven't been able to get much done. I mean, even something like Keystone, you know, I mean, that's our hope. That somehow that can, you know, be finalized and we can get that done. Being able to, you know, have oil independence here in the United States, although I know it's going to be produced from Canada, but you're still talking about an abundance of American jobs over the course of 2 years. That's a lot. That would produce a lot more, you know, money in our pockets, being able to make us financially independent. And quite frankly, I don't want to have to rely on places like Russia for fossil fuels. Mm-hmm. I don't want to have to rely on places like the Middle East, which war torn and just ravaged.
Well,
want
nice
to be able to be independent.
Now, right? It's nice going to the pump.
Absolutely. But what happens if all of a sudden they start adding taxes to that?
Is that what you're willing to get the Keystone pipeline? What is your trade?
And that's, you mentioned that before, and I thought that was really important. The fact that, okay, you get Keystone, but what's going to happen in return with that? Where are we going to start to see some of these taxes? Because they've got to make revenue somewhere.
Okay, the circus has come to town. Get your popcorn. Get your cotton candy. We'll see you next time.